rock.
They are ready to.
7:01, I'd like to call the meeting to order. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call for attendance. Joanne Shirkey.
Here.
Mark Bouchard.
Here.
Sandy Kufal.
Here.
Krista Regan.
Here.
Kristi Hilton.
Here.
Artie Bryson, absent excused. Cindy Valentine, here. I would like to make a motion to have trustee O'Regan chair the meeting in the absence of supervisor Artie Bryson.
Support. Oh, no, are you making a motion?
I'm making the motion, yep. Support. Any discussion? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Okay.
Thank you for coming, everybody. It's a very chilly night, and I appreciate you showing up. We were, last meeting was out at the island where we had very good reception. Geez, I'd say there was plus 40 over there. So it's always nice to see people from the community in town. We're going to move right through the agenda today, and the first item of business is bills payable.
I'll make a motion for bills payable in the amount of $102,800.50.
Support.
Okay, we have motion and support. Can I get a roll call vote?
Mark Bouchard.
Yes.
Sandy Kufal.
Yes.
Krista Regan.
Yes.
Kristi Hilton.
Yes.
Cindy Valentine, yes. Joanne Shirkey.
Yes.
Motion passes. Thank you, everyone. Next, we'd like to open the meeting up for public comments. If you have any public comments, we'd encourage you to come up to the podium. Please state your name and address, and you will have 3 minutes. Any public comments? Seeing none. Next item of business is our consent agenda.
I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda consisting of the board meeting minutes of January 22nd, 2018, and synopsis, check reports, the January police building and zoning reports, the 2017, which I believe should be 2018, annual workshop for St. Clair County Metro Planning Commission, and there was no communication or requests.
Support.
Seeing we have motion and support. Can we do an all in favor vote on this? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Next order of business is a supervisor's report. The supervisor's report is my interpretation of Mr. Bryson's handout. So here we go. Here's my crack at it. The supervisor's report was written as of the 1st, and looks like we're going to have our annual road meeting on February 26th at 1:00 PM at the Road Commission. If any of the trustees are interested in joining Mr. Bryson, it will be held up at the Road Commission. And road projects for this year include, and currently on the docket for a repaving project, I believe, on Marsh Road between Benoit and Chartier, on Swartout Road from Morrow to Starville. Both projects will start in June and be completed sometime in July. Anchor Bay Drive will also be replacing the first two bridges scheduled for this year, and the anticipated completion date, they'll be finished by October the  18th. Mr. Bryson, our supervisor, also went to Lansing last Wednesday, and he met with Dick Posthumus, who is the Governor Snyder's chief of staff. He also met with Dan Lawers, who is the Speaker of the House and next term Speaker of the House as well. His points of topics were talked about revenue sharing, medical marijuana issues, and several local control issues. Mr. Bryson spent the afternoon on the House floor. We also had Mr. Bryson also had a mediation session with the MAFF January 23rd over outstanding issues. There is another session scheduled for Friday, February the 9th. The asbestos abatement has now been completed at 5244 Point Trumbull Road, and the water department will be tearing it down sometime in short order. John? Awesome. Lastly, on the supervisor's report, we have an upcoming event, which is the Winterfest. It's scheduled for February the 16th through 18th. Looks like it's put on this year again by the Pearl Beach Lions Club. Friday, the February the 16th, it looks like it opens at 5 p.m. At 8 p.m., the Meldrum Brothers Band will be in the big tent. Saturday, February 17th, looks like we have ice fishing registration starting at 8:30. We've got the Derby between 9 and 11:30, the ice fishing derby at the Harbor Club. There's face painting, there's breakfast at the big tent. 1 p.m., Rapture Birds of Prey Show, admission of $1. There's kids games. And at 8 p.m., the band Soul Provider will be in the big tent. There'll be a $5 cover charge, which includes one refreshment. Sunday, February the 18th, looks like the show kicks off at 10 a.m. and winds down somewhere around 1 in the afternoon. That was a good event. We'd encourage participation by all the community members, and outside participation is encouraged as well. Supervisor's report's done. Next, we're going to move to the fire chief's report. Chief Rose. Thank you. Thanks, Chief.
Thanks, Chief.
We next would like to move towards the police chief's report, but I don't see Chief here in the room.
The chief is unable to attend this evening at the last minute. He did ask if we could postpone his report to our next meeting, which would be on February 20th.
Great. Do we need to motion to move that?
I can motion to postpone the police chief report to February 20th.
Support.
Great. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Any opposed? Doesn't look like we have any unfinished business.
Nope.
Wonderful. Next, we have some new business. There are about 8 items on our agenda for the new business. The first of which is some technology and IT service. I believe we have Mr. Courier in the room tonight. Mr. Courier, could you approach the podium? Thanks for coming, Josh.
Well, I was told everything from you don't need to be here to just be here.
going in the direction that the IT resources that they need are there and that the security is in place that they need. Advantage Tech manages about 700 clients throughout the Midwest, Georgia, and Florida. Pretty much wherever the CEO wanted to move, I guess, is where we took off. Manage right about 10,000 computers on a daily basis. We are based out of Chesterfield, which is where all the support is, starts. And yeah, that's who Advantage Tech is. When I first got called, a lot of it was about email, and kind of came in here and spoke with some of the board members and found a lot of things that were, I don't want to say undone, but a lot of unknowns that are things working, but nobody really knows, well, I don't know who to contact for this, or I don't know who to contact for that. So the goal of Advantage Technologies would be to take that under their wing, finish off any projects that need to be finished off, as well as create a one-stop shop for most of the questions that they need. We're not going to replace everybody you guys will ever have to call, but we can be your one call if you're unsure. So if you're having an email problem, you can definitely call us, or any sort of IT-related question. And even if we're not the right person, depending on what plan you go on, we can either reach out to them on your behalf, or at least say, hey, no, here's what you need to know, and here's where you need to get to, and really create a resource for you guys that can provide also things for PCI compliance that you might need for processing credit cards. Trying to tell you a lot in a short amount of time. So, most of you guys know who I am and what I do because I've helped you in some capacity throughout my years of being around here. So I'll open up to any questions.
Will you be able to access our internal programs?
Yes. Well, part of the management that we do is we do install an agent that monitors the computers for any sort of failures, errors, and part of that is, yes, we would have access into your systems. Primarily, if you guys have a program that is password protected, we don't ask for your password. So once we're in, yes, we can get into your computer, but unless you give us, so we work in a lot in the medical space with HIPAA, so we're all HIPAA compliant and everything you might need on that. So for example, in that space, we can get into their computer, but to get into their practice management, normally we don't document that stuff, but we can get into.
But it will be tracked.
Yes, it's tracked, logged. Everything's based off the ticketing system. You guys have access to that to open tickets. See your tickets, get inventory reports, anything you might need. Every call is recorded that you would call into our support. So that was another tough one. I'm expecting some real duties here. The big thing that I saw when I came in here, just in about a half hour that I was in, is really the need for some security and some IT security. Part of what makes Advantage Tech unique is we're very transparent about our costs and what we do. And what we've seen is a lot of people, if we go, we don't want to be the company that says, hey, we're going to charge you this much per month, and then your firewall's up for renewal, and you get hit with a $2,000 bill from Dell. Part of the Plus and Pro plan, I wouldn't even look at the Essential, that's really not designed for somebody like you guys, is that we will provide a security firewall for you guys, all the updates for that. When Dell sends the renewal, you guys don't even see the bill. It is our equipment, but part of that is we will update it. We will put in switches here. We will put in Wi-Fi. We will manage all of that for you guys.
Is there a specific entity that you'll use for the firewall and our security?
We use SonicWall for that. For the gateway AV portion, we use a combination of different products, so that way we're not tied to, if Dell has a problem with SonicWall, I don't want that to be the only thing. So we also use a different program on the local computers for the antivirus, all cloud-based managed. But SonicWall is the one that we use for the content filtering. Ubiquiti is what we use for the Wi-Fi, which is definitely needed. I've been through it for that, so it's painful. The other thing that you guys needed that's not on there, the monthly cost, that's an estimate. We bill basically for workstations and servers. I didn't get, Artie wasn't 100% sure how many servers you guys had at the time, so we based it off what you guys gave me. Could be less, could be more. But that is, what I want to do is kind of give a little bit of an idea, so that way if you guys looked at it and said there's no way, then we're not wasting anybody's time. The other big project that you guys talked to me about was migrating your email off of St. Clair County, I think currently hosts that, to Office 365. Whether you guys go with Advantage Tech or not, I was telling Cindy this, you guys need to go
100%.
So the fun part's going to be is migrating you guys off your current platform onto that. Depending on what you want, where your mail is located, we are, I think we're talking about 100 mailboxes. So we do charge for the onboarding. It is done at an hourly rate. If I have to spend 2-3 hours with every employee, well, you can do the math. But if we can find a quick way where, no, let's just spend the time here, we'll do whatever you guys want to do on that. Once you're on that platform, whatever Microsoft charges is what we would push through to you guys, or you can pay them directly.
Where's your IT room located at?
Our IT room?
Yeah, your offices.
Our offices are in Chesterfield. Mm-hmm. It's where we do most of our support. Actually, all of our support, unless for some reason a field technician from one of our other territories is home, then he would be helping us out. But primarily, he'll be speaking with people.
Would you be opposed to what, having a fire chief go down there and take a look at your facility?
Sure. You can come in. It's going to be very boring, very dorky. I'm this guy there, and that's not saying much. So we don't have any on-premise servers. We kind of eat what we eat our own dog food. So we use Office 365. So if you're coming in expecting some dorky server room.
Not there?
It's not there.
So you don't have a CO2 backup system with dry valves and?
No, we have a fiber connection. That's about as good as we get, and that's not even something we really wanted. But it's painful to make VoIP calls with Comcast down. So other than that, you won't see anything. But by all means, you can come in. I'll buy you lunch and see a bunch of people.
Well, I was just thinking, if something happened here and we needed a secondary place to still do the business, would that be the place to go?
I mean, you could definitely come use my office. I don't, Chris has been there before. I don't know if it's necessarily what you guys are accustomed to. I don't have fancy chairs or anything like that. But that, something like that is a great question, where we could definitely come into play if you said, hey, Josh, there's a need for us to have a backup plan for should we not have power here. Right now, I don't know who you guys would call for something like that.
Do we have anybody?
But we could definitely provide, I mean, that's a very legitimate question because we have, well, what if our building's without power?
Yeah, right.
We could definitely say, hey, here's who we use that could have what you need, and here are the IT systems that would or wouldn't be available to you at that facility. We'd definitely facilitate anything you might need on that.
Good.
Whether or not you want to sit in my chair, totally up to you.
I don't think so, but
I know.
Maybe
I
Cindy.
It would be a down. It would be a down.
No, I certainly do not.
So,
good.
So, Josh, this monthly amount, is this a, like a 5-year contract? Is it month to month?
No, so that's the beauty of Advantage Tech. I would say one of our core values is integrity, and we want you guys to partner with us. When Clay Township wins, we win. So if there's a way that we can find 5 servers and consolidate down that down to 2, what we've seen with a lot of other managed service providers is they'll shun away from anything that's going to cost them money. Office 365 is a great example. Mm-hmm. Or managing exchange servers and stuff like that. Whereas we don't. I'd rather you guys be on something that works better for you guys. Yeah, you're paying us less, but overall you'll be much happier, which will make the relationship last that much longer. So as far as Advantage Tech, it's a 1-year agreement, but you have a 30-day out at any time.
Okay.
If you're ever unhappy with Advantage Tech, we don't want you to feel trapped, because guess what? If you're not happy, we're probably not happy, and nobody likes that type of relationship. It's just not fun. But yeah, if you guys are looking at other companies, I would encourage you. A lot of them do charge you. They'll lock your systems down for you. So if they're managing it, they're going to lock it down. It's going to be theirs. Although it's your equipment, it's going to be theirs, and then you have to pay to get out. We kind of take the opposite approach. It's your equipment. Other than the services that we provide, it's your equipment, it's your stuff if you're not happy. So it's time for you to go.
Yeah, I wish the chief was here, Mike. See how that would coordinate with the fiber optics coming in. But
yeah, I did speak with him for about an hour.
Oh, did you? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
The fun part's going to be is if he's a really good guy. He's got a little bit of stuff over there. We had just talked about taking him on as well. We'd obviously have to service them in a little bit different capacity because they have a lot more vendors that they deal with that you guys do, and we also have to see how you guys are tied into them. Because
mm-hmm.
The last thing I want you to do is call me when your phones aren't working and me not be able to tell you, at least who to call. But I did speak with him. He had interest. And
okay.
So I would encourage you, actually, I think the email that I forwarded over to you guys had him on there.
Okay.
Yes. Yes, I believe the chief is trying to figure out how to work that into his next year's budget. They don't have a big IT budget over there right now. So that is a possibility coming up for him in June.
I mean, the biggest thing I want to be transparent with you guys is the onboarding. You will talk to somebody. I think Christy can attest if you ask Chris. Somebody, one of our competitors, will offer free onboarding. If that's what you're looking for, that's definitely not Advantage Tech. We'll do whatever we can to onboard you guys as efficiently and most cost-efficient we can. But until we know exactly, I mean, I had a one-hour meeting with Artie. Until we know exactly what we're dealing with, I'm not going to come in here and say, yeah, we'll support you guys. We'll be $1,000 to onboard you. If you guys look at the monthly, once we get you past to a supportable standpoint, and the 1,330 is kind of where you'll be monthly, obviously outside of any service calls you may have, our goal is that you have none. But if you look at that and say, you know what, yeah, that's something that's definitely in the budget. What I told Artie I would do is come in and spend a few more hours and try and really peel back some of the layers that we have here to try and get you guys a more definitive amount that we need to onboard you guys. And the big one on that is going to be the email. If I have to sit down with 100 people, have email on three different things and merge them in, well, that alone is time. And there is no migration. I don't know why, but St. Clair County or whoever does not provide one.
Okay.
Any other questions?
That was easy, huh?
Nice job, Josh.
I gave it my best shot, so.
So currently, the township has a budget, and we pay by the hour, kind of as needed.
Yeah.
So it's difficult for the township to budget and forecast what our future needs are going to be, which makes the budgeting process even that much more difficult. We do anticipate that partnering with Advantage Technologies would probably cost us somewhere between $4,000 and $5,000 more than we're currently paying for our pro plan. But we're expecting that you would be able to deal with BSNA and other third-party issues,
yep,
including Office 365, which obviously ranks up there as of really, yeah, high importance to us.
Absolutely. I mean, both those, one, when you're looking at sheer cost, make sure you look at some of the other things that a lot of people charge for.
Mm-hmm.
As far as on the plus or the pro, we do, to answer both your questions, we have what's called vendor management. What we've seen is a lot of you guys, if you're having a problem with your software, the minute you call them, they're going to say, well, it's your computer or it's your computer network. Outside of training, if the software is working correctly and you're just calling because you're trying to move a payment from here to here, you guys can call them directly for that. But if the program's not loading, the program's running slow, the program's not functioning how you guys feel it is, you can open up a ticket with us and we will call them on your behalf, so that way when the inevitable happens and they say, well, it's your IT, we say, well, that's fantastic, because that's who's on the phone, and we really take that off your plate for doing that. So that's one of the answers to one of your questions. And as far as the hourly cost, once you're onboarded, all of your support is unlimited and it is free. So as long as you don't have any add moves or changes, is what we consider a service call or on site. Once we've onboarded you, we got your computers to a supportable point. If Christy were to call up because her computer is acting weird and we have to spend 2 hours working remotely on trying to fix it, well, you've not added, moved, or changed anything, it just stopped working. We will fix that. It's all included as part of your plan. And on our pro plan, it does actually include a service allowance for you guys, should you need on-site help or, hey, we want to update this software, which would be a normal service call. It comes with an actual monthly allowance to give you more of that one flat fee, as well as a bunch of other things that probably don't have time for, but I'm more than willing to answer any of those.
Would you be able to monitor the upgrades to our programs as they come on board?
Yeah, that's something we can do. What we've seen is every client has a little bit of a pain threshold. Everybody immediately goes into it saying, we want the latest version of everything, and then they realize, well, why are there patches 2 weeks later? So if you guys are ones that would like to be one version behind, you know, so that way you're kind of working on the latest stable version, we can absolutely, you know, accommodate for that. We have some clients that have a lot of accountants that want their QuickBooks updated every week. Mm-hmm. And we can definitely take care of that. It's really where your pain threshold is for jumping on the latest and greatest stuff.
Well, a lot of times it's demanded by the program administrator. So.
Yeah. Usually you have to be on the latest whatever version, but not maybe,
right,
11.1. But it's something that if you guys were to call us up and say, hey, we want to go from this
That was the last hard question I had of myself.
So there's a lot of points in there under where it talks about the Advantage 360. One thing about us, if you're not interested in Advantage 360, we are not the right company for you guys. So if you're like, well, we don't want to go with them for the monthly IT services, but we want them to do the Office 365. Going back to the integrity thing, I've never seen that be a good thing to say, hey, we're going to do this and then just walk away and say, well, you didn't sign up for anything, so we're going to wash our hands of it. If that's what you're looking for, there are plenty of companies that will do that. Our goal is to establish a relationship and be there for you guys for your ongoing needs. So if you want one without the other, if you want Office 365 migration without Advantage 360, we're probably not the right company. In fact, I can assure you we're not. Because I want to be able to see you guys around town. I'm going to not be fixing your phones. So there's a lot of other points on there. You'll see some bulleted points between our plus and pro. If you guys have any questions, we have everything from failover servers, should your server die, cloud backup, we manage all of that, the antivirus. You don't get a bill for any of that. If you guys want everything from a failover server that pushes to the cloud, so should the building burn down, we could light you up virtually. We do all that. I'm not going to bore you with technical details. But it is on there, bullet pointed. Some plans it's included, some of it's not. My email address should be on there. If it's not, most people here have, you want to talk about a specific point, more offline, I can do that for you. So.
Well, I will say, we do pay for the county to administer our email right now, so that would be something we wouldn't have to pay, which runs about $1,000 a year. So that kind of helps close the gap a little bit. And we also do pay for our antivirus software and all of our desktops separately, so that kind of helps close our gap a little bit too. But there's definitely been a lack of proper IT service here for the last few years, which makes things quite frustrating sometimes.
So they closing the gap a little bit, but if they're giving you $1,000 a year for your email for 100 boxes, not my cost, Microsoft's cost is going to be significantly more than that. I think the minimum you'll get 100 boxes from them for is right about $400 or $500 a month. So it's a much different platform than what you're on now, so it's hard to compare what you have now compared to where you're wanting to be. I mean, everybody wants everything, but if they were doing everything you needed them to do for $1,000 a year, that in mind, that cost is not an Advantage Tech cost. That correct. Is right from Microsoft's website. Depending on what license you want from them, obviously you guys can Google that yourself if you'd like to see what the actual plans come with. So,
yep, we did get the pricing from Microsoft.
I think it was $4 a box right around there for just an email.
Yep, $350. Yep.
Okay. So $350 right there just for a month, just for that. I think you can get a little. That's if you pay yearly. Either way. Just keep that in mind, that's not to us. We can't have that on the agreement where you just have to pay us a bill and we'll just pay them directly. So, no, we can't do that for you, or you can pay them directly. So, really, the next step for me, besides answering any more questions if you have any, is if you guys look at this and add up all your bills and say, hey, you know what, we do want to dive a little deeper into this, just let me know. I'll come in and spend whatever time I can to really try and drill some of the onboarding costs and more of the monthly down to a better number.
So can we expect a consulting fee for you know, your analysis of our current situation? You know, we're just trying to look for our next step forward.
It depends on how deep you want to go into it. If you're just looking for, you know what, at the end of this, we're okay with the monthly, right, you know, somewhere if it being in there, and I have to come in for a few hours, you know, I'll do that as a courtesy.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's what we would do for anybody else. But if you guys are wanting, hey, we just want to present this and we want an audit of everything we have and we want it, then yes, we could set up some sort of consulting. But just to let you know what the onboarding would be and some advice for the basic stuff, I'll do that. That's no issue.
Well, we think time is of the essence. What's the board's pleasure? So we're looking for an improved security,
yep,
right? Office 365 integration, increased cybersecurity, increased and improved firewall, a little more transparency, mm-hmm, workstation and server efficiencies, and some of the onboarding that's crucial to what we have.
Yep. So, I mean, you have to go down that punch list. If you have any specific questions about one of those, you know, by all means, let me something's going to happen, and it's going to be painful, and it's just a matter of time. That's my assessment based off spending about 3 hours with you guys. There's a lot of things that are hanging by a thread. What those are, well, I don't want to necessarily pinpoint this right now because I don't know enough, and I don't want to.
We don't want you to. No, we don't want you to.
So.
Thank you.
Well, you answered all my questions that I was concerned about. However, I'm not an end user. There's only three of us on the board that are primarily end users, so
yeah,
I would leave it up to them to see what.
I'll retract a little bit when I say hanging out with Red. I think a lot of it is more the end user side. I think you guys aren't getting that type of stuff. I'm not saying your servers are in disarray or Rome is burning or you're being actively hacked or anything like that. So let me bring that back a little bit. But as far as the end user stuff, I don't think you guys are getting on that. Basically, off talking, I know I've talked to Christy a couple times, and she's had an error on her computer that they're basically just saying, well, just deal with it. But to me, that's not an acceptable answer.
Okay.
So that's more what I mean by her computer's going to crash or may not. So I don't want to kind of retract that.
We're interested in developing partnerships as well. But let me go back to your original statement. So if we were to make a motion and support the motion with enough votes tonight, given the proposed monthly allowance, we still have 30 days to analyze, correct, and or cancel?
You're actually not signing up for the monthly right now. We don't actually start charging the monthly until we will give you guys a more formal proposal. Here's what the software costs, the initial onboarding. Here's what that looks like a lot more in depth. But what I wanted to do, what we've seen is some people get all excited. Oh, yeah, we'd love a number to call. We'd love all this. And then we say, well, there's a monthly fee associated with it. And they say, well, I wish you would have told me that at the beginning. And we wasted our time. So you're not actually, even if you say, yeah, let's dive a little deeper, you're not actually committing to anything or any sort of money at this point. You're just, all I'm looking from the board is basically some sort of a, yeah, if we invest the time and the onboarding looks where we need it to be, that monthly doesn't scare us. So, or there's a budget for that. And the you can go to Office, if you don't go to Office 365, I don't really care. But I would highly recommend it. That's really what I'm looking for tonight.
That's where we need to go, Josh.
Yeah.
I don't think there's any question about that with this board, especially with the state of the IT at the moment. But I think this is a good time to dive into our IT situation. In the next month or so, we're going to be preparing budgets for next year.
Okay.
So if there is any costs that are going to explode that we're not expecting or anything that we may need to purchase or look into, now would be a good time to do that, rather than after our budget year starts and have to wait a whole new year because, you know, we didn't budget properly for that. So
what'll do your next board meetings in a month, right?
2 weeks.
I don't know if I'll be able to do it in 2 weeks, but I'll try my best. But if not shortly, I'll be able to give you guys, if you guys are okay with proceeding forward, I'll come here and spend some time with Christy and Artie and Cindy and really try and do a little bit deeper dive. Cindy, if you could start gathering some of the bills, that any bills that you get that you think might be IT related, so I can kind of say, okay, you would have this one or you wouldn't have this one, so that way we can really start comparing the numbers.
Okay.
And then I'll have a written formal proposal for you guys to look at and approve, hopefully within 2 weeks.
That'd be spectacular.
Do my best.
Okay. Confident in you. I think you have it.
Do we need to make any motions to proceed further with that, with Josh?
Just a thought here that I have. If it's 2 weeks is too quick for him, would the following meeting, like the 1st of March, would that be too late for us?
No, that'd be fine.
I don't think it'd be too late.
Instead of putting him, trying to hurry.
Well, I like trying to push him a little bit. It's okay. He's really good at it. He works good under pressure.
I need some email.
Okay. Well, I mean, you guys know more about it than I do, because you work with it all the time.
Yeah. I'm sure I have an hour a month somewhere.
Just an hour, Josh.
Yeah, I'll do my best. I mean, I just wanted to touch base. I already wanted me to come here to you guys and just kind of talk about what we did. There is no financial commitment or anything. As long as we're okay, I'll do the next step. Cindy or Chris, if you want to email me tomorrow, I'll get with you guys and we'll arrange a meeting to really get you. I know last time I was in here, I didn't have one of the server passwords, which he said he had access to, but he didn't at that moment. So we'll get all those in a row so we can really dive deep into this.
Okay.
Have fun.
Sounds
All right, so if I may, why don't we give Josh a vote of confidence? So I'll make a motion to give Josh a vote of confidence to move forward to the next level, in the next step.
I would support that.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay.
Perfect. Yeah, if you guys have any questions, let me know, and in a couple of weeks at the earliest, I'll have something a little bit more in depth for you.
Thank you, Josh.
Thanks a lot, Josh. Next on our new business, item number two. We currently have our township website is in need of renewing and refreshing. It needs to be brought up to speed and proposed in front of us. We have a fixed cost to do so. Everybody get a copy of the proposed revise invoice? Then I will move forward to entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve the revised invoice with the staff directory in the amount of $750 removed. Cindy Babish did check with our sales person at Revise that she has been talking to regarding our update and refresh, and that's not an issue to remove that. I just think it's a little high cost right now for something that is not all that mandatory. I'd rather see our website get up and running. It's something that we can add at a later time. So the annual cost for the website is $24.96, and the additions that we wanted to add to the website was the homepage alert system with e-notify for the building department and the news integration with Facebook and Twitter. And those costs are $940, so it'd be a total of $34.36.
Support.
So the removal of the staff directory, can you give me a definition of the staff directory and what that
entails? It is a list of the staff by alphabetical order with their contact
information. The entire staff or the board, like we see on the yellow cards?
Yeah, it's just a long page. It has everybody's name by alphabetized and the department they're in and their contact information. Looks rather nice. It's very clean looking. Considering we're having other issues with worrying about our IT, I just don't think that that's something that's that important and essential at this time. Correct. Thank you, Joanne.
Okay, thank you.
Additional discussion on the revised invoice?
What does the news center integration with Facebook and Twitter consist of?
There is a, I think it's in the spotlight right now on our website. Very similar to that, whatever we would post in there. From our user end, we would be able to link directly to the Facebook pages that the township manages.
Gotcha. Thank you.
Rather than having somebody copy and paste and go into each of those.
Any more discussion? Mark? Joanne? Okay, we're ready for a vote? We have motion and support, correct?
Yep.
All in favor of supporting the revised website renewal and refresh invoice in the amount of, a proposal in the amount of $3,436, signify by saying aye.
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 Yes.
All opposed? Motion carries. Topic number three, under new business. Code enforcement. So what we have in front of us is our code enforcement officer has asked for a clothing allowance. He said he needs boots for inspection. He is our part-time zoning enforcement officer. And also remind the board that we have two other part-time inspectors as well. So what we do for the good of the goose, we do for the good of the gander, correct? So the topic before us is a clothing allowance in the amount of
conflicting, is it 100 or 150?
Well, the paperwork that Artie submitted for the board packet was 100, and then Mr. Pratt submitted a memo to the board today that was 150. So I'm assuming he's going with the, he's looking for $150. No, he is not. I will say at this time, the township does offer a clothing allowance to employees that have it within their contract. However, our assessors also don't have a clothing allowance, and they also have contracts with the township. So I, not that I am opposed to it, however, right now it's not something that is budgeted, and I think this extends beyond just our code enforcement officer. I think this also will extend to our building department, our assessing department. I would make motion to table this for now, and I have no problem putting it in as a budget review item for upcoming year. But I think right now it's hard to squeeze in an allowance for a varied amount of people. And I would hate to just single Jim out and do it for him, just himself.
So your motion is to table?
Table the clothing allowance.
The clothing allowance?
Mm-hmm, for the next budget year. And we can bring that up in our budget workshop.
That's motion. Do we have support?
Support.
All in favor of tabling the clothing allowance request, signify by saying aye. Aye.
Aye.
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed, signify by saying no. Okay, new business number three, the clothing allowance is tabled. Next, item number four, the annual contribution to the Algonac Clay Historical Society in the amount of $2,500. It's something historically that, pardon the pun, that Clay Township does on an annual basis. We support the Algonac and Clay Historical Society and have continuously supported them and plan to support them again, providing the proper vote. So we will entertain a motion.
I will make a motion to continue our annual contribution to the Algonac Clay Historical Society in the amount of $2,500 from line item 101.265.965.01.
Support.
We have motion and support. All in favor of the motion, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
All opposed, signify by saying no. The motion passes. Next, we need to set a public hearing for the Colony water line.
I'll make a motion to set a public hearing date for Colony water line for March 5th, 2018. Seven p.m.
I'll support that.
We have motion and support. Can we do an all vote on this? Mm-hmm. All in favor of setting the public hearing for the Colony water line on March the 5th, signify by saying aye.
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 Any opposed? The motion passes. Next, item number six. We have is resolution 2018-03, the Colony Drive Waterline Special Assessment.
Is Barb here?
Yeah. Barb?
Barb, would you mind coming up to the podium?
Do we coax you for a couple of minutes? You so inclined to enlighten us?
This is quite the project, especially for this somewhat new board. It's not anything that I think that any of us have gone through at the township, creating this own special assessment. Now, we've set the public hearing date and have a resolution in front of us. My understanding is this resolution is just confirming the public hearing, that we set the public hearing date. Yes. This is one step in a process of many.
There will be several resolutions. This is the first resolution to set the public hearing date, and then there will be another resolution.
Okay. So does anybody have any other questions for Barb?
At the first public hearing, people at that time will
Thank you, Barb.
One of the first steps of more to come.
First step of many.
I will make a motion to approve Resolution 2018-03, the Colony Drive Waterline Special Assessment, Resolution 1 of 5, Water Supply Distribution System, Colony Drive, Clay Township.
Support.
Do we need a roll call vote on this?
We do.
Please.
Sandy Kufalt.
Yes.
Krista Regan.
Yes.
Kristi Hilton.
Yes.
Cindy Valentine, yes. Joanne Sherkey.
Yes.
Mark Bouchard.
Yes. So the motion passes. Item number 7 on the new business. What we have is set before us is a repair proposal. And it looks like for a couple of gas detector repairs, Chief?
Yeah.
Can you give us a brief summary?
We have 3 detectors in our department.
Yep.
And I have 1 that's operational in the mainland. 2 are needed to be fixed. 1 was dropped and needed to be sent in. And the other one, I'm not sure from the last time it was calibrated.
Yep. Great. 1205.
I'll make a motion to approve the gas detector repair for $1,205.
Support.
Motion and support. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion passes. Last order of business in the new business. Looks like some promotions are in order. Looks like, Chief, we have some potential promotions set before us for the firefighters.
Yes.
These are command recommendations for promotion. And the 4 people that are listed, these are what they intend to be promoted to?
Yes, sir.
Great. So it is the intention to promote Mr. Carl Bailey to the assistant chief, Mr. Ed Folk to the position of captain, Mr. Bill Huber to the position of lieutenant, and Marta Walsh to position of sergeant. Is that correct?
Yes.
Is that a motion?
That's a motion.
Okay. I'll support it.
You'll support that motion?
Yes.
Thank you, Joanne.
Are any of the candidates here in the audience?
Yeah.
May they stand, please?
Carl and Ed.
Names?
That's.
This is Ed Pope and Carl Bailey.
Okay.
Carl and Ed. Thank you. So we have motion and support. Any more discussion?
Chief, can you go over some of the qualifications on the candidates?
Which ones do you want?
Why don't you go with all of them? I see you got a nice little letter here for them all. We had an earlier discussion on it, and I think this pretty much surmises it. So I guess just read this, and then I'll be done with it.
Okay.
All right. You want this? Where you going? Right, okay. Go ahead.
I'm calling Carl Bailey to assistant chief.
Yep.
He's been on the department for 8 years. Years of experience in the fire department.
officers we have in place with these promotions.
Five of us right now. We need to move forward.
Okay.
Got it. Mark, comfortable with the rundown?
Yep, thank you.
Got the information you're looking for?
Thank you.
Okay, this one is gonna require a roll call vote. So, do you wanna piecemeal these out?
Sure.
All right. So I'll entertain a motion on the assistant chief's position.
Motion to approve Assistant Chief Carl Bailey.
Support.
Roll call vote, please.
Chris Oregan.
Yes.
Kristi Hilton.
Yes.
Cindy Valentine, yes. Joanne Shirkey.
Yes.
Mark Bouchard.
Yes.
Sandy Kufel.
Yes.
Motion passes.
Motion to approve Ed Folkey as the new captain of our fire department.
Support.
Kristi Hilton.
Yes.
Cindy Valentine, yes. Joanne Shirkey.
Yes.
Mark Bouchard.
Yes.
Sandy Kufel.
Yes.
Chris Oregan.
Yes. Entertain a motion for Mr. Huber?
I will make a motion to promote Bill Huber to lieutenant.
Support.
We have motion and support, roll call.
Cindy Valentine, yes. Joanne Shirkey.
Yes.
Mark Bouchard.
Yes.
Sandy Kufel.
Yes.
Chris Oregan.
Yes.
Kristi Hilton.
Yes.
Last but certainly not least, entertain a motion for Mrs. Marta Walsh.
Make a motion to appoint Marta Walsh as sergeant.
Support.
Roll call, please.
Joanne Shirkey.
Yes.
Mark Bouchard.
Yes.
Sandy Kufel.
Yes.
Chris Oregan.
Yes.
Kristi Hilton.
Yes.
Cindy Valentine, yes.
Congratulations.
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 Thanks, chief. Appreciate the rundown. Next, we have board member comments. Sandy?
I just wanna congratulate the four promotions that we approved tonight at the board meeting, and thank you, Chief Rose, for all your hard work. I know you've had a lot going on with grants, and I see the department really moving forward, and I wanna commend you for that. Thank you very much.
Kristi?
I would also like to say congratulations to everyone, and thank you. I see you running around everywhere, and we all appreciate the hard work that you're doing.
Cindy?
I would just like to point out to everybody, our next meeting will fall on a Tuesday, and that is due to the offices being closed for President's Day. So usually when the office is closed, they also push our board meeting back to the next day. So it has been scheduled for Tuesday, February 20th, instead of Monday, and that will be at 7 p.m. And I also want to congratulate everyone that was promoted tonight in the fire department, and Chief Rose, good job on running your butt off while the ferry was open, closed, open, closed, open, closed for the last week. We appreciate it.
Thank you, dispatch.
Thank you, dispatch. Joanne?
I too want to congratulate the new officers to the fire department. It's glad to see us moving forward. And I'm sure George has had a good training start with ferries closed. No, ferries open. Oh, no, it's going to close tonight at 10. No, it's good. And so it was a good training session for Chief Rose. And I attended the Clay Algonac Historical meeting last Wednesday. They said it was a very important meeting, so I thought I better go to it. And they do an awful lot. And if you have never been over to that museum that they have in the old bank, it's something to see. And they are currently going to make a boathouse in there with an old Algonac hand crank hoist. And it's just an amazing place.
They have room for that, huh?
Yes, it's a big building. So do take the time to go over and visit. And they, like all the other historical people, are getting historical. And so they're always looking for... I didn't say that right. They're looking... you know, running out of time, and they can't do this anymore, and so they're looking for volunteers all the time. So I'm giving them a little plug, and if you can help out, be sure to do it. And they have a new president who's awful excited to be the president, and she took it because they couldn't get anybody else, I think. So it was rather interesting meeting. I really enjoyed it. So, and she said to me, is Artie going to see that we get our contribution this year? And I said, I'm sure that'll be taken care of.
Very
so
direct.
It was on there. It is on
very
there
direct.
Tonight. Yes, yes.
She's
yes.
probably watching.
Just so we know, it wasn't Artie.
No, I know it's not. But that's what she said. You know, I'm just quoting her. Yeah. So anyway, it was a good event for me to attend. I wholeheartedly support him.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Finished?
Yeah, finished.
Mark?
It's a hard act to follow. The Planning Commission has approved the site plan for the old Allen Boat facility down there. You'll see some activity coming soon. We'll be opening up a cabinet and kitchen shop, such as it is, and with the residents on top. So that site plan's been approved. This Wednesday will be a public hearing for the discussion of setback revisions, as well as the recreational animal
the chickens.
Ordinances. So,
not the chickens.
And that's it. Thank you.
Great.
Make a motion to adjourn.
Not quite.
Okay.
Not quite. But it'll be quick.
Chris would like to get his.
Oh, Crispin.
Yeah.
He's been talking all night.
I know. Yeah, he's just like Artie.
I'll be brief. Listen, I want to give a shout out and express my gratitude for the first responders of the township. So what really hit me is you know, when I'm in my office and I see the police go by, or I see the fire department go by, or I see the water department working till 10, 11, 12 o'clock on water main breaks, I'm most grateful. It's easy to take that for granted in our township. And we have men and women that will do anything for this township and do on a regular basis. So I just wanted to say thank you for all the fire department, all the police department, all the water department workers in Clay Township. Thank you very much.
Well said.
Lastly, I'll entertain a motion.
Motion to adjourn.
Board.
Approved. All in favor?
Yay.
Aye.
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 Josh took up half the meeting.
Thanks, Josh.
I wasn't sure where we were gonna end up going.
Hey, George.